12/21/2014. Congratulations, everybody. This is the day. This is the day that our lease is up on this planet. You see, we've been leasing this planet, and the lease is up today. This is the big day. We have three options now. We can either choose to buy the planet, or we can decide to lease another planet, or we can let go of the dream of structure altogether. Now, the third option, let go of the dream of structure altogether, I say, that's great, but we have a severe continuity fear and virtually no one's going to do that, okay? So, the second option is to lease another planet, at least another dream structure, at least another definition of what we are. And the third option is to try to buy this planet, you know, stay here for, like when you get a car lease, you know, 3 years, 36 months, if you buy it, payments for 6 years payments to buy the car. So if you decide to buy this world, it means you're going to try to stay with this world for another cycle. You're going to say, yeah, this is our home. This is what I want. This, and okay, buy it. So we now have those three options. Just like when your lease is up for a car vehicle, you have to bring it into the dealer. They say, what you going to do? What you going to do? You going to walk away from it? You going to lease another car, or you going to buy it? That's it. Those are the three options we have. So it's great. What are we going to do? Well, I said option number three is no structure at all, which is really reality. I mean, waking up from the dream of definition entirely. The continuity fear precludes that for virtually everybody. Unless, you know, there's maybe a few who have evaporated their continuity fear to the extent they don't even need any structure anymore. Okay, fine. But for the rest of us, option two would mean another dwelling place. Okay, another dwelling place, like another car. This world is really like a car, and our bodies are like a seat in the car. Okay, so you come to this world, you lease this world, meaning you're leasing a seat in a car. Okay, that's, you know, basically what it's like. This world is just our attempt to define what we are. That's all it is. That's all it is, just a dream of definition. Now, we can't be defined because we're absolute freedom. The isness of absolute freedom, how can that have a definition? It cannot be defined at all, at all. To try and define it is to deny what we are. So it's not really definition, it's really a denial of what we are. But how can we deny what we are except through definition? So we have this denial of what we are in the form of definition, trying to define what we are. That's all this world is. It's futile. It's useless. What we are can never be defined. In any way. So, but we say, wait, I'm used to this structure, definitional structure. So, I'm used to driving a car. I don't want to just be like the wind, free as the breeze. So, I want another car, but I don't want it to be, I want to set down definition altogether soon. So I don't want the car to be all definitional, you know, too busy with definition. Great. So we have an option for a world which is designed to help us set definition down, actually. This world is designed for us to increase our efforts toward definition. And it's why everything I've said, everything's going to pivot. Everything's going to pivot as we go into 2/15. And today's the pivotal day, first day of winter, 12/21. It's the pivotal day where we make a decision. Are we going to decide to buy into this world going forward? And basically align ourselves, say, this is our vehicle, this is our seat, this is the definitional path I want to go on, this world. Okay, we can choose that way. Or we can just say, you know what, I don't like this. This isn't me. I feel this does not help free my spirit, you know, from definition. This world, the way it's going, is not designed to free my spirit from definition. It's designed to to try and you know, work even stronger in trying to define what I am. So I don't want that. So I want some different vehicle, so to speak. Now maybe this seat can be transferred into another vehicle. That's perfectly possible. Why not? Why not? It's not the seat so much, it's the vehicle. Okay. It's not the body, it's the world. It's more the world. The body is just a seat in this vehicle we call the world. Like a seat in a car, you can take a bucket seat, take a seat out of one car and put it into another car, no problem at all. You just bolt it in. I mean, it's like, it's not that difficult at all. If everything fits, but you can make it fit. This world is designed for is to try to convince ourselves that there's a co-reality, that we've been able to create a co-reality that's now part of a greater reality, of the reality God created and the reality that we have created, and that God's reality is a reality of no structure, perfect freedom, and our reality is a reality of definition and structure and non-freedom, a process. A creation of process, and that these two creations are now one creation, one mega creation, that's better than before. This is what this world is designed. That those who want to work on this, come to this world. This is what this world is for, actually. This is what we've made it for, designed it for. Now, if you are waking up from this delusion and realize it's impossible. God, we don't have the power, function, to create a different reality. Then you say, wow, what do I need this world for then? I don't need this world, this is ridiculous. So you would say, okay, I've leased this car for however long, 3,000 years or something. And now, you know what, I'm tired of this car. It doesn't really suit my personality anymore. It doesn't suit my belief system anymore. This car does not suit my belief system, just like a style. People trade in their cars. They say, you know, this newer car reflects who I am a lot better than the older car. So I would say that this world may not reflect our beliefs or what we want anymore. It's like a car. Say, okay, well, I don't want to continue with I don't want to buy this car. Lease is up. Don't want to buy this car. So it's just decision time. I've been saying this over and over. It's going to be decision time, decision time. We have to make a decision on what our destiny is. So we just decide, okay, I'm going to trade it. I'm going to lease a different car, different vehicle. Vehicle is a world. Okay, or you can even call it a realm. A realm. You could even go that far and say it's a realm. So this is the benefit of being spiritually aware, is you're aware of these lease periods. You know, you're aware of what's going on. Cosmically, spiritually, you're aware of what's going on. Where if you're just frantically in this rat race and not paying attention, I imagine most people on this planet are unaware that the lease on this planet has expired. That's why it's a new age now. There's a new age. They're unaware what their options are. Unaware what their options are. Not paying attention. So they're just keeping swept along, thinking, oh yeah, I just have to keep this world. I have to keep this world. So keep in mind, actually, that we don't have to. We do not have to buy this world, buy into this world. We do not have to. So let's just let this settle in information as we practice this full stop in the wow, the surprise. You know, it's the spiritual path is like getting used to being surprised, which a lot of people don't like. They don't like any surprises. They say, I don't want any surprises. Well, the spiritual path is full of surprises. And so you have to have this discipline, like, wow. Like, just this was explained to me this morning by the Holy Spirit. Leases up. I said, wow. It's a big surprise. I didn't quite understand it before now. So, surprised. And this feeling of surprise is a feeling that a lot of people don't like. And they try to stay real busy and active to try to, you know. But what we do is we stay very quiet and still. This is the best way to deal with surprise. Because obviously, wow, it's a wow. Like, this is a game changer entirely. The lease is up today. And what it means in practical purposes is that the world has now been incorporated by the cosmic corporate culture, and they're now in calling the shots in this world and demanding compliance with their management structure. That's what it means. And their management structure is designed for confusion about your options. So you're confused about your options, and you think you have to buy this world. You don't realize you're leasing the world. You think that you bought it, and this is it. And so this motivates you to keep working on trying to define what you are. And so that's why so many different people are coming into this world now are heavily, heavily, heavily into self-definition. Because they knew that the lease is going to be up, and the old ways, which were more clear about the options, realizing, hey, we're just leasing this place. You know, the religions teach that basically. This world is not my home at all. You know, Jesus said, this world is not my home. You're kidding. We're aware of that. Whereas the new cosmic corporate culture, who now has incorporated this world into their corporation, their vast cosmic corporation, they're not aware of that, you know, they're not really aware of that. And they're hell-bent on this co-reality notion that we're going to have a reality where we define what we are, that we're going to define what we are, whereas God created us free of all definition, you see. So, they're hell-bent on defining what we are, and so this world now will reflect that purpose and motivation. And there's the nervousness, the agitation, it's all jazzed up, the glamour, glamorized, you know, everything is like that. So people will be interested in bodies and buildings and cars and structures and all this stuff. Oh, maybe it's this. Look at this definition. Look at this. Look how I define this car. Look how I define this building. Look how I'm defining this body. This is what they're into. You see? Whereas those who decide not to renew the lease and get a lease on a more spiritual realm, spiritual dwelling place, there it's like your feeling is like structure seems to like sort of like gently fade away there as you're looking at that realm. If you just feel like sort of like dissolving into a breeze, you just feel like being a breeze, you know. It helps. So it goes in the opposite direction. It induces this feeling of like, hey, I don't even need structure at all, actually. I'm free as the breeze. It lends itself to that. So, two very different experiences for sure. So this explains why I've been working, so seriously, frantically seriously working, knowing that, decision has to be made. Decision has to be made. Now, living in the Silicon Valley helps out, because this is really a Pacific Rim country right now. California is a Pacific Rim country. And you get the feeling of what it's going to be like in this world. This is how the world is going to be like. If you just go around in Silicon Valley, you feel, holy cow. The intensity of definitional focus here is just extreme. And I just, feel like, say, whoa, I don't want this. No way, no way, no way, no way. Now, I did have a dream when I saw when the world collapses into compliance, which is confusion about their options. They don't realize there's any other option but this world. This is severe confusion. When the world collapses into compliance with the New World Order, I was able to escape and go to another dwelling place, another world. And when I got there, I was quite surprised, really surprised and amazed. So I'm sort of practicing for that. When you're amazed, how do you respond? You don't go into a coma. You stay alert and aware and awake, but you just sit quietly. So sitting quietly is a super, super important skill to have. I would say it's the most important skill to have by far. Being able to sit quietly and still and keep your mind steady. The most important skill we can have. The other stuff, not important. It's a transitional skill. It's a skill that enables you to transition into a death-free realm. Anyway, when I got to this other dwelling place, I said, hey, can I stay here? Because you know what's happened back, in the other place, it's terrible what's happened. And so, I can't stay there. And they said, yeah, we know all about that. We know all about it. Nope, it's just, you're absolutely welcome to stay here. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Great that we're super happy you're here. Glad that you're here. I mean, the hospitality was just off the charts. I felt totally welcome. And what I was amazed at was I said, wow, this world is way, 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 way better and more beautiful and more peaceful than the place I came from. It's like way better. I said, wow. Dude, that's the surprise. And you just have to gradually get used to it, that's all. Hope House, in that is a place of hope where we realize, hey, I can drop all definitions of what I am, of all whatness, and just accept I am, just I am. That's our identity, I am. That's identity. That's all identity, not just ours. Identity is I am. Nothing else is identity. So there we realize, hey, I feel like I can set down definition. Gradually I get used to this and I can set it down, sure. Now this can even be done in this world, which is the yogis and the adepts and caves in various meditational, they would, it's possible. It's possible to do it here. But this now end of this lease period in this world, it's a very, very different ballgame. Even though it will always remain possible, wherever you are. which does not set down all definition, but which is kind of the final definition, which is sort of dissolves into no definition. The final illusion, which makes all illusions unnecessary. Final definition, which makes all other definitions unnecessary, and then which then enables us to say, ah, we don't need any definitions. I am. Or just amness, freedom, pure freedom. Severe sneeze impulse. I just used my will to dissipate it. Now, the attraction to this world, to this world that we've been leasing, okay, that we have been leasing, actually, all structure, dreams of structure, we're just leasing. None of them are real. You cannot make it your home. It's impossible. So, buying it is a delusion. Believing you can buy it is the delusion you want to avoid at all costs. This is the lie that cosmic corporate culture is telling us. That we can buy this world. No, you can never buy nothing. Okay? You can never, there is no structure actually at all. But it's an illusion of structure. So believing you can buy it is the worst lie of all. Now, our attraction to this world is like a sneeze. And if you like, I just have to sneeze. Oh, the tingling, the itching, I just have to sneeze, you know. In other words, I just have to compulsively try to buy this world. Buy into definition. I have to buy into definition. I have to buy into structure. I have to make that co-reality. This is like this a sneeze that's building up, and you have to sneeze. So, you just stop. And what I do is just, I focus everything on that. I say, I'm not going to sneeze. And then finally I have to bring my will in. And I say, I will not sneeze. I will not sneeze. And end the discussion. And that's when the poof, vanishes. So, when I say, well, I hope I don't sneeze, I hope I don't sneeze, I don't want to, it's still building up. And I say, uh-oh, I'm going to fail, so I'm going to sneeze. And then I have to go to the will and say, I will not sneeze. And I just take control, my will comes in, and then it's gone. So we have to say, I will not continue buying in with this definitional structure. I will not try to buy this world. Sneezing, it's trying to come back. So the world's just like a sneeze. When you sneeze, you buy the world. You try to buy the world when you sneeze. If just keep it, make it seem like if you sneeze, that means you're going to buy the world. That's your decision. If you say, if you stop the sneeze, no, that means you're going to lease a different dwelling place. This is like, make it like that crucial. It's a way of practicing. Saying, I will, and then you have to use the will. So I've tried to explain how terrible this world is and will be, and tried to help people practice stillness, sitting quietly, which enables you to get adjusted to something way better. See, what the spiritual path is about is adjusting to great news, really great news, adjusting to it. And when you're used to something really terrible, you know, even though you see something great, you're not used to it, and you'll shy away from it. Automatically, you'll say, I don't know how to function. I don't think I can function. It's too good, too nice, too good for me. I'm making a fool of myself. So this is a continuity issue. We're afraid of less definition, less structure, less definition. So what the world is doing now with this New World Order, cosmic corporate culture, New World Order, centralized bureaucracy, is to get more and more and more structure, more and more and more order, structure, definition. Everyone is going to be Define. This is what you are. Paperwork, electronic, data. That's what these smartphones are about, is training people into more and more definition of what they are. And then tweeting and social media. Okay, I did this. I took a picture of this. I did this. These are my friends. This. Structure. And everybody just calculating, constantly busy, you know, with that smartphone. Structuring the future, structuring, more and more structure, faster and faster pace of structuring, definition. So the definitional pace is going to pick up now in the world. The intensity of definitional effort is going to experience a quantum leap. This is what's called the New Age. Which is actually... Here comes again, Dad. The New Age is really a descent into confusion, which is darkness. Spiritual darkness. We believe that if we just go deep enough into darkness, our freedom will be conquered. And structure will be true. And so we keep going deeper and deeper and deeper into darkness, trying more and more and more. But meanwhile, we feel spiritually alienated. We feel something's wrong inside us. And we become, you know, it becomes more and more difficult for us. It's just futile effort. The lease is up. Now, we may not feel all gung-ho about, hey, we'll lease a different car. Because of the continuity fear, that's why. Spirit understands this. Spirit's not looking and say, who's like all eager and saying, yeah. No, Spirit understands that we may really want at least a new vehicle, different vehicle, but a continuity fear makes our reactions very subdued. You know, just say, okay. Like if someone would say to me, I'm going to take you on this vacation right now to this wonderful, beautiful place, what would my reaction be? I just sit quietly is my reaction. I wouldn't react hardly at all. Why? Because I'd be preparing for it, that's why. Because I know when I get there, it's going to be a continuity shock. So I would start preparing for it right now. Which is what I've been doing in these videos, encouraging everyone to do this. If someone said, yeah, all expense trip to Hawaii and the most beautiful resort there, and indefinite stay, you know, all expenses paid and your bills taken care of, blah, 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 blah. What would be my response? No response. I'd stay just full stop in the wow. And just not think ahead at all and just be focused just on full stop in the wow, being quiet still. That's it. So at this time in the world, you may not see anybody jumping around and shouting, hey, hallelujah, you know, because the ones that are going are likely to be very quiet and still right now.
Dad, are you buddy Noah?
Yeah.
So in other words, we're not trying to anticipate what it's going to be like, but that's structuring, definitional structuring. We understand it's going to be less definitional structure, so the way to practice that is to just practice full stop in the wow. Because what it's going to feel like is wow. That's what it's going to feel like. And you're not going to be, you won't feel like, hey, I don't really need to define this place, is what you're going to feel like. Just let it be what it is. I don't need to define it. It's perfect. Just let it be. So we have to practice that. Practice. Just let it be. Let it, everything just be. I don't have to label or define anything. So, like this world is a car, our body's a seat, and the seat has a name, that's not our name, it's just the name of the seat. This model seat, this is called the so-and-so model seat, which is just a definitional structure of the seat. We are not a body, I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit as God created me. Part of this, I'm quitting, sitting, full stop in the wow, is you're dropping definitions of this world too. You're not trying to focus on anything in this world. any definitions, any structure, any thinking, any thoughts. So the end of the age, it means the end of the lease. Okay, we had a lease on this world. There was a lease on this world, and that lease is up now. Another way to put it is a corporation, you know, had a lease, some corporation had a lease on this, and then at least expired, and then another corporation is now taking over the lease of this world. In that case, that the world would be like a car, a bus that the corporation owns, and you're a passenger on the bus. Of course, they decide where the bus is going. You know? The corporation decides where the bus is taking you. So you may say, well, I don't want to ride on this bus anymore. No, thank you. I don't like where it's taking us. Get on a different bus. So again, all expense paid trip, you're going to some, you know, fabulous place. What's the reaction? Someone just informs you this. But this is likely what's going to happen. And you just, you know, no response. Just, okay. Full stop, no response, that's full stop, because it's just a wow, that's all. It's wow. It's like, but there's so many responses, it's all just a wow, right?
Okay, ready? Yep.
So just get used to that, just get familiar with it. It's like a shock, staggering mindness. If you make the effort of will and stay with it, gradually, you know, it will soften, and you'll feel more functional. Certainly, any time we're brought out of our comfort zone, our functionality seems to drop, and you have to recognize what's taking place. Then you have to feel okay about that. Recognize it. If we don't recognize it, then we'll believe we're confused and panic. Or say, what happened to my functioning? What happened to my functioning? And start panicking. Whereas if you recognize, oh, this is a continuity fear because I'm absorbing the good news. Oh, okay. Then you say, okay, I know that in a little while, if I just stay with this calmly, stay calm, don't struggle with the struggle, that my functionality will return, in fact, be even better than before. This is the whole key to the situation. If you find yourself in, one moment, please. So again, the key is, right now, is to avoid the confusion. When you're shocked with good news, when you're taken out of your comfort zone because of the great good news, you feel temporarily dysfunctional, like, whoa, I'm not sure how to function. Calm and poised. If you don't panic, then you'll be able to make a transition into the better situation. If, on the other hand, you just feel like, hey, I need to feel functional. I want to be functional all the time. And I'm confused about my functionality. What happens is you start panicking. You start panicking over this. And then you get in this feeling like disorientation and confusion. And it's very frightening. Very frightening. Okay. So this is the pivotal situation that I've been working with the world here on this all-important issue. Say, okay, my functionality has taken a big dip. Fine. Great. Thank you. Love it. Because this means I'm absorbing the good news of a way better situation. And as I absorb this good news with gratitude, forgive myself for all my foolishness, absorb the good news, be a little patient with my functionality. Gradually, the continuity fear evaporates, and I feel like really feel like very super functional. You know, it's great. Be able to function in the better situation and within the good news, the context of the good news. This is the key to success. So just when you see confusion, say, "Oh, that's continuity fear." Okay, that means that I'm temporarily staggered mind. My functionality has dipped way down. Good. Say good. That means I've heard the good news. All right. Let me just sit here quietly then. Don't try to function. See, sitting quietly, you're not trying to function. So it enables you to absorb the good news, go through this period of temporary dip in functionality, and then come out the other side with, oh, I'm familiar with the good news now, and I feel my functionality seems to be returning in the context of the good news. Transitional practice here. This is the key to transitional success. So just realize that there is this key. Okay, it's called the continuity fear is the only problem I have. If you're confused, insist. The continuity problem is the only problem I have. I do not have a confusion problem. I have a continuity problem. Okay. And the continuity problem is what's driving this, right? So you can even say, I do not have a functioning problem. I have a continuity problem. Continuity problem is the only problem that I have. Vision of oneness. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness. Meaning, what does that mean? Vision of oneness means there's only one identity. Our identity is singular, not dual. So only the vision of oneness has value to me. Because in seeing that, it resolves the continuity fear. And the vision of oneness still has some structure. Okay? So it resolves our continuity fear. We say, oh, I see that identity is singular. And then from there, we realize, oh, identity is I am. Or just am. Isness. Okay. We will keep working on this. Pivotal day. The lease is officially up. That's it.